What's up, everybody? It's me, Kitrollup. How's it going? Been a while. Missed you. So lately, I've been doing a lot of the gym. Doing a lot of gymming. A lot of getting to know James. And thought it would be fun to do a week of my life and what I've been doing as far as my health and my fitness and all that is concerned. Wouldn't that be fun? Today is Monday, and Monday for me is back day. So I'm going to safely drive to the gym in the rain and show you guys my back workout. Sounds fun, huh? So before I got into what my actual workout and everything was, I wanted to go through a little bit of discussing what my... There we go. like the nutrition and things like that, because I feel like that's important, you know. It's important to know what you eat, what you put in you. For the past few months, I've been doing the keto diet. I eat a lot of fat and protein and no carbs, though I cheat all the time. I'm really bad at it. I'm kind of a lazy keto. Just, like, all weekend, it was just carbs. I had carbs. I had burritos, sandwiches. I didn't care. But most of the time, I eat, like, a lot of meat and stuff like that. Dutch. Hey, good. For example, today I started off my day with a large bulletproof coffee, which is a black coffee with heavy cream, no milk, heavy whipping cream. I use Stevia as a sweetener, because no sugar either. I haven't had sugar for over 90 days, which I'm very proud of. And then I take a tablespoon of butter and a tablespoon of coconut oil, and I put it all in the blender and blend it to bits until it's frothy and delicious, and then I drink that. And that was my breakfast. I also had a snack of a single hard-boiled egg. Was quite nummy and delightful. For lunch, I had a combination of hot wings, cauliflower stuffed chicken breast, and a concoction I made of beef, cream of chicken soup, and green beans. That was quite good. And then I had a Quest bar for my second snack, which is a delightful protein bar for us low-carbers out there. Yummy, yummy. I also have been drinking so much water, like all the water. Like, just all the water. It's just mine. It's all mine. What's up, y'all? Here at the gym. Getting ready to go inside and do some gym stuff. First, I gotta take my medicine. I've got this little concoction here of drugs. You know, steroids, human body growth hormone, all that goodness. It's actually some pre-workout that I take, combined with a little of this other stuff. Don't remember what it's called, but it's for, like, the keto thing. It helps your body use fat for energy, stuff like that. Usually when I do my workout, I start off with a warm-up. I normally do 10 minutes on the treadmill, but I am unable to run at the moment because of an ankle injury that I sustained a while back. So we're gonna instead do some time on the elliptical. And then after that, I work out my upper body, my warming up, by doing three sets of 5 pull-ups, 10 push-ups, and then I throw in 10 squats too, because Yeah, why not? Do that 3 times and bam, I'm warm. Ready for the beginning of the lifting. That's where I'm gonna pick up again in a moment. So just give me a moment. So it's kind of funny. When I got my ankle injury, saying that I couldn't run, it was about the first of the month, last month. So by the time I got to the doctor, and I got a waiver saying that I shouldn't do any running exercises and everything, because being in the military, you have to have proof or whatever of your ailments, otherwise you have to go and do everything. Go run when I tell you to run. Blah, 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 blah. Anyway, the waiver is for 30 days, and when I got my PT test scheduled, I tried to fit it into my schedule in such a way that it didn't clash with anything else. So, for example, I've got leave coming up next month. I'm going to visit my family. They're actually coming to watch my brother perform at a college up near San Francisco. I'm gonna go join them for that. But I wanted to get my PT test taken care of before then. So I scheduled it before that. And little did I know that when I scheduled it was actually the day after my waiver expires. So technically I should be able to run that day. But if you've ever tried to run a mile and a half in less than 12 minutes, you kind of want to have a month of, you know, getting warmed up to that, not a month of not running at all. So I'm gonna have to see what I can do to fix this problem. Because the elliptical is just not gonna be enough training for running. But yeah, fun story. All right, so now I'm gonna work on my upper body warm up. I've been doing it at about 50 assisted pull-ups, but I'm gonna step it up a notch and I'm gonna drop all the way down to 20. Because yeah, I was able to do some pull-ups without any assistance last time, so I might as well step up my game. Let's do this. All right, so for my first actual workout that I'm gonna be doing, it's a lot similar to that warm-up, only it's more endurance-based. I'm gonna increase the resistance, well, not really resistance, assistance on the pull-up, because I'm gonna be doing 20 followed by 10 push-ups, or no, 20 push-ups. Then I'm gonna knock it down to 15 followed by 20, then 12, 20, 10, 20, 10, 20, like that. So this is more of a endurance thing. Lower or higher reps, lower weight to tone and build endurance as opposed to build and strengthen. So that's my goal for this one. So yeah. So I'm giving myself a bit of an intermission right now in my workout because I'm gonna do a class, bike club. It's kind of a additional cardio sort of thing with strength training involved. And I think I'm gonna have some fun with it. Yeah. All right, so I finished my class and of course, the only lat pulldown machine that's available is the worst one in the building. But that's okay. So I'm just gonna knock it out real quick. Do lat pulldowns, 4 sets of 12 is what I usually do. All right, so the next thing that I do is a seated row. Good times. Starting off at 110, 4 sets of 12. Simple stuff, easy. I'm going to proceed to the last workout of the day, which are back hyperextensions. I hate those so much. I don't want to do them, but I gotta. 20, what is it? I do 25, 20, 15, and 10. It's gonna suck. All done. Official total time at the gym is 2:15. 2 hours and 15 minutes. Good day. Good day. Ah, it feels great outside. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, that was Monday back day. It was an all right one. Today is a special day, because today they are releasing the Szechuan sauce at McDonald's for everyone. And of course, I have to go get some. Light, don't leave me, no! So I'm off to McDonald's, but that's okay, because let's see, hold on. I have, that workout, according to my Fitbit, was 1,000 calories. 1,004 to be exact. See? Can you? Oh, there it goes. No, you can't see it. If you didn't see it, too bad. But yeah, so I can probably splurge on a chicken McNugget or two. I think I'll be okay. Yeah. That's Monday, and I'll see you guys in like a second for Tuesday. Happy Tuesday! What's up? It's Tuesday! It's my favorite day! It's chest day! Chest day! Chest day! I like chest day! I'm ready to get pumped! I drank my potion and I'm ready to go! So let me tell you a little bit about my day so far. I went to work. I walked like 3 miles, I think. Something like that. I ate like the exact same thing I ate yesterday, except no boiled egg this time. Now it's time to lift heavy things with my chest muscles. I'm gonna give you a little rundown what I'm doing today. I'm gonna do my warm up, obviously, same thing I did yesterday. Then I'm going to go straight to the bench press. Gonna heavy haul. 12, 10, 8, 6, going up in weight as I go down. Then when I get to 6, I add a little more weight and do 4 sets of 4 at the heavy weight. And that's my bench. Then I like to, after that I'm gonna do incline press, 4 sets of 12. I'm gonna throw some push-ups in there too. Just give more pump, more muscles, more pump in my chest. Get big. Then after that is the machine press, basically just another chest press with the machine just to add a little bit more oomph. Then is cable flies, my favorite. And yesterday I was not able to do abs, so I'm going to do abs today as well. I'm gonna do some planks, side planks, leg lifts, do some toes to bars, all that fun stuff. But that's my Tuesday chest day, and I'm ready to do it. Let's go. All right, so I just finished my warm up, and I want to show you guys something funny that I noticed last time I was here. So I'm on this chest press machine, right? Now, watch this. Maxed out, which is about 310 pounds, if you can see that. Now, let's see if I can set this up so you can see it. I cannot bend 310 pounds. That's ridiculous. Just so you guys know, be careful about the machines that you use, because
sometimes they just don't, they don't work properly.
Oh, I hate planks. But I find the best way to get through them is to distract yourself. Which is why I'm talking right now. So what to talk about? That's the tricky part. Well, I think after I finish my ab workout, I'm gonna go sit in the sauna for about 20 minutes or so. Sweat a little water weight off. I like to finish my exercises in that. I like to finish the day off if I have time. Oh. Right now I'm doing a minute of planks and a minute of side planks on each side, and then leg lifts. I got 10 seconds left. Yeah. Almost there. Oh. Yeah.
Chihuahua. That was a good chest day. I had a good time chesting, doing chest stuff. Yay.
I also worked my abs so much. They hurt. They hurt so bad. So it's time to go home and get some food. Whatever it is that I decide to eat. I don't even know. I guess we'll find out. But yeah, leg day is tomorrow. I'm gonna do leg day at a different gym because I don't like doing legs here at this gym. I'm gonna do them on the base gym. So I will see you guys then.
Gym time. It's Wednesday gym time. Gonna do legs and stuff. It's gonna be great. All right, so today we had a promotion ceremony. And as with all promotion ceremonies, there was cake. Oh, I wanted it so bad. I love me some cake. And this looked like some yummy cupcake. They were cupcakes. And with this like really soft, fluffy looking icing that is, want so bad. But I have been over 90 days sugar free. Trying to make it to 120. 120 days sugar free. Then I'll have, you know, a little bit of sugar every now and then. Nothing wrong with, you know, a jelly bean from time to time. But I wanted those cupcakes so bad. But I refrained. I was good. Well, here I am. I'm at the gym. That was my drive. All right, so what I'm going to do today is leg day. After my warm-up, I'm going to do some squats, deadlift, leg press. And the way that I do leg press is a drop set. So I start out with like crazy high weight and then I take weights off as I go down and I just go till failure. That's a lot of fun. Then I'm gonna do lunges, then leg extensions and leg curls. And I might throw in some hip flexor stuff as well, some abduction. That's legs. Let's go hit it up, y'all. All right, so it looked like the whole CrossFit class and their family was there, gathered around the squat rack, doing, you know, CrossFit stuff. So I'm gonna go to the other gym, I guess. Hopefully it's not too busy there. But yeah. What are you gonna do, huh? Oh, I am officially done. I can barely walk downstairs. I can walk across the ground pretty well, though. Oh, that's better. Sun. That dreaded sun ruining the shot. Okay. 3 more days left in the week. That's right. I do 6 a week. I'm hardcore like that. Tomorrow's shoulders. Friday's arms, and I do a hard cardio day on Saturday. Happy hump day, everybody.
I'm gonna set up my shot.
Is it on? Hi.
What's up? It's Thursday. I have a guest, a friend, a buddy for the rest of the week. Say hi.
The rest of the week. The Thursday and Friday.
The last. Well, I'm doing Saturday too. So.
Yeah, you do that. I don't.
You should come with me.
No. Weekends are for not doing anything.
Sundays are for not doing anything.
The entire weekend is for not doing anything.
So today is shoulder day. Do you have any idea what we're going to do today?
No, because you haven't told me when I asked.
I know. I was waiting. So we're going to start off with a... We're gonna start off with a military press. Military press. It's called, is it shoulder press? Straight up shoulder press. It's called a military press. And then we're gonna work on Arnold presses, which are a lot of fun. You're gonna love those.
I get to press Arnold.
Yeah, you get
to press Arnold. I've been lusting after Arnold Shortman since I was 9 years old.
Arnold Shortman?
That's Hey Arnold's last name. It's Shortman.
I'm talking Arnold Schwarzenegger.
No, I want to press against Arnold.
No.
He's legal now. We're both
wrong.
Legal. We're like 30.
Wrong. Wrong.
Arnold presses are named after Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Wait, he didn't invent them.
Yeah, he did.
Did he?
Yeah, that's why they're named after
him.
It's a special shoulder exercise that he, like, invented. Anyway, after the Arnold presses, we're going to do front raises, lat raises, and then we also got barbell shrugs, which are a lot of fun.
I be the master of shrugging?
You will be the master of shrugging.
I'm going to just be shrugging all day, every day, and then when people see me at conventions and they're like, free shrugs? And then I'll just be like, shrug! Like,
you're going to have massive... freaking...
You don't know what that is.
I don't know. I don't know what the muscles are called. I know what a bicep is. And then the other one on the other side is three of those.
The one, other one on that side is three of those?
Yeah.
Okay!
Doing abs again. Mm-hmm. Always abs. Everyday abs. Train abs every day. You get sweet abs. Like these.
Yeah.
All right, let's get started. We're cutting shoulder day short because my shoulder injuries are acting up and it hurts too much to continue.
Fine by me, I'm leaving.
It's so painful. Like, holding the camera up is almost too much for me right now. But that's a good day. I just hit her with my bottle of water.
No, what you did was you're flinging your bottle of water around. Membership thingy on them.
Okay.
Pinch my finger with the metal of the case.
I'm sorry. Was not intentional, I assure you. Alright, so arm day tomorrow. We're gonna have fun. I like arm day. It's not as fun as chest day, but it's close enough. What? Where are you going? Why are you leaving me?
Why are you leaving me? Don't leave me! Baby, don't hurt me, hurt me, hurt me.
Baby, don't. You're gonna love me, love me, love me. Copyright. Guys, help us. We are the worst people.
What did I drop?
I dropped something.
Hopefully you're also driving.
I know. We're the worst people. We got Jack in the box. After doing so well at the gym. It's so dark, I can't see a thing. Hi! Yeah, we got Jack in the Box. And like, not even like a little. Just bought like all of it.
Now we're gonna watch Coco!
Yeah, we got Coco, we bought Coco. Which is a great movie if you haven't seen it.
So what day is it today?
Your mom.
That's incorrect, try again.
Catil's Day.
Catil's Day, that's right, it's Catil's Day, everyone. Which means arms.
And arms done on different days?
Because they're different? I don't know.
But they're part of your arm?
Yeah, but by that logic, your shoulder's part of your back.
No.
Yeah, totes.
No.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Probably. Anyway, the reason we do it on a different day is because that's how we have it set up.
That's how I do it.
Okay, whatever.
Hey, my keys are in the truck, so I have to go back and get them.
Okay, so back what I was saying, arms, it includes bicep and tricep and forearm, which means we're going to be doing lots of curls and push things, like up push and pull down things. And
up push.
Yeah, up push.
Up push sounds like the best exercise.
We're gonna do
the up push.
30 up pushes.
Not
push-ups, up pushes. What do you mean you don't exist? You're right there.
Ow, because I'm right next to you.
You've been there this whole time.
I've been right back here.
No, you haven't.
Well, you film down here.
I film however I want to film.
That's how you're supposed to film.
Hi guys, what's up? It's me.
Yeah, damn right.
I don't know. She beats me daily. Yeah. Help. All right. Say hi, Doki. So the first exercise we're doing today is the barbell curl. Doki here does not have a barbell. She's going to be using these 5-pound weights. You're going to take one in each hand. Yeah, one in each hand. There you go, just like that. You'll be fine. Stand up. You gotta stand up to do this. Well, you gotta. I don't care. All right, and so what you're basically just going to do is curl.
And that thing we did yesterday?
Just curl. That's not what we did yesterday. We didn't do barbell curls. There you go.
Actually, I don't get a barbell.
Because they don't have a 5-pound barbell. And the dumbbells are missing.
My fingers can't fit.
There are no. You don't need to fit all the way through. You just need to hold it. Alternate hands, it'll be a lot easier. Whereas I am going to be using this thing right here, the 55 pound. No, you're gonna do 10 on each arm. Yeah, just like that. The next exercise we're going to be doing are called skull crushers. What we're going to be doing is lying on the bench here. Where's the tricep? Lifting this over your head. There you go. Now bend your elbows to where it comes down to your face. Now just straighten your arms. There you go. That's one.
How many am I doing?
10.
This seems like it really hurt my face.
Well, don't drop it on your face. That's why it's called a skull crusher. Because if you mess up, you crush your skull.
That sounds like the same thing to be doing every day.
It is. You want to curl your, flip your hands over.
Why didn't you tell me that? I just have like
over. I mean, that's another curl you can do, but it's way harder. There you go, look at that. As many as you can. Don't forget to breathe. I
I think it's too easy for you. We should go up. Have you done 10?
No.
Okay. All right, one more. Do it. What? Because you're, it's like cardio. Yeah, go ahead. All right. Proud of you.
Muscles hurt.
I did notice that today was Friday because it was arm day. And you did a good job, by the way.
Aw, thanks. I'm pretty sure I still got it.
Well, everybody sucks at one point, then you get better. It's rainy.
It's sprinkly.
It's wet. Different. It's wet and chilly.
Not wet.
I'm wet.
Lightly misted.
It's too wet for me.
Oh, okay.
And it's cold. Anyway.
Run home, Nate.
Yep.
Zucchini taco boats.
Zucchini taco boats for a delicious time. All right, so that was our Friday. Saturday, I do a cardio thing, which is a timed thing, so I'm probably not going to record it.
I want to do that.
Yeah, well, that's fine. I don't want to either. I hate it. But yeah, so... Oh, that smells so good.
I know. Okay, so here's the thing. Side note. Okay. Our gym is across from... Food?
All the food.
And food.
All the food.
Food.
There's food everywhere.
Food.
Gym.
All
and then more
it.
Food.
And it's birthday.
So much food.
Amazing.
Yeah, it does. So good. It's so wet. No.
Did you get the car?
I am. Escaped in car.
Swear.
Safe. We are safe. So yeah, cardio tomorrow, and then that's my week. So, yeah. Neat. Hey, anything to say?
You didn't do a cutscene with your taint this time.
Well, that's okay.
No.
Maybe I'll do one now. All right, so what do we have for dinner here?
You know,
We've got some... zucchini boats?
Zucchini taco boats.
Yeah, they got ground beef and cheese and on a zucchini, which is pretty good. But then we were thinking, we hollowed the zucchini out and we didn't want to let that go to waste because that's a wasteful thing, right?
Yeah.
So we thought, you know, maybe we could turn it into potatoes, right?
Zucchini potatoes.
Zucchini potatoes, because you can make potatoes out of cauliflower and other stuff. So we took some... The zucchini pulp, put it in a blender with some heavy whipping cream and
cheese,
sour cream,
cod liver,
some cream cheese, you know, try to make it flavorful. But it was just like so liquidy, it was pure liquid.
It was like ranch dressing.
Yeah, like ranch dressing. So we thought, well, let's put some fiber into it because fiber's good. So I added a couple scoops of psyllium husks, and that worked. It made it thicker. And then Kareen was like, even thicker, I want it more thick. And so I added another scoop.
Thickies.
And this is a bowl of slop.
That's a plate of slop.
It's okay, it's a plate of slop.
Poke it. Just...
Oh my god, it feels like flubber. Or the what is that stuff? What is that? That slime, the Nickelodeon slime?
Have you tried
Nickelodeon
slime?
Gack.
Oh god, no.
It feels like gack.
Oh no.
This is
gack.
Oh yeah,
gack. By the way, we are going to eat this.
Yeah, this is, it's actually quite delicious. Because it's filled with the extra taco meat and some more cheese and stuff. But
it's very keto is what he's trying to point out, because we're eating keto.
Yeah, we are
eating
keto.
It's very keto.
This is very keto, but it's also just,
We could post the ingredients and call it keto mash.
Keto mash.
Keto gack.
Keto gack. It's keto gack,
guys.
Put
it on Reddit and call it keto gack.
All right, but yeah, I just wanted to share that nonsense with you guys.
if we go for dinner time. I am running out of battery as we speak. Good night.
Hey, can I help you?
Hi there, how's it going?
Doing great, how are you?
I'm doing great. Hey, do you guys have the Szechuan sauce?
Yes, we do.
Excellent, that's awesome. I am going to have a Grand Big Mac.
Okay, would you like the combo or just the sandwich?
We'll go with the combo.
Medium or large?
We'll go with a medium. Oh, no, I'm sorry, large. We'll do a large.
What would you like to drink?
A Coke.
Okay.
And then could I also get, let's go with 2 10-piece chicken nuggets.
So 20-piece?
Well, I suppose that'll work.
And then you want the sauce, right?
Absolutely.
I can give you up to 5, is that okay?
Yeah. That's perfect.
Anything else, please?
Yeah, I'll also take a double quarter pounder with...
The sandwich alone?
Just the sandwich with no bun.
Did you want a lettuce wrap?
Yeah, absolutely.
Anything else?
No, that'll be it. Thank you, you too. A boy, Szechuan sauce. Ha 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 ha